In our liver clinic, we see lots of patients that have misconceptions about both what makes their liver sick and what makes their liver well. We see a lot of patients that come to us with the thoughts of, can I take something for my liver? Is there an herbal cleanse that I can take? The short answer is no. In general, most of the supplements that help detoxify or cleanse the liver, they really are nothing more than a way to spend some money. The bigger concern is that herbal and dietary supplements can actually cause a lot of damage in the liver. As a class of agents, herbal and dietary supplements are the second most common cause of drug-induced liver injury. When you think about prescription medications that are FDA approved, they go through a very long vetting process of clinical trials. Herbal and dietary supplements don't go through that vetting process. So we just don't know if they will cause liver toxicity. Cirrhosis is the advanced stage of liver disease. But it can be caused by alcohol, it can be caused by hepatitis C, but it can also be caused by a myriad of other liver diseases, such as autoimmune liver disease or non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. Because of the obesity epidemic, the prevalence of non-alcoholic fatty liver disease has skyrocketed. We estimate that one in every four people in North America has non-alcoholic fatty liver disease. Non-alcoholic fatty liver disease is caused by elevated blood sugar, so diabetes or prediabetes. It's caused by gaining weight in your midsection. It's caused by high triglyceride levels or cholesterol problems. We think that non-alcoholic fatty liver disease is going to be the number one cause of liver transplants in the next, say, 10 to 15 years, maybe even sooner. None of this is to discount the damage that alcohol can do to the liver. And unfortunately, the group that is having the highest increase in alcohol-related liver disease is young people, people aged 25 to 34. When patients come to see me with abnormal liver tests or a new diagnosis of some type of liver disease, very often they're concerned that that means that their liver is failing and that they're going to need a liver transplant. And more often than not, in fact, 90% of the time, that's just not true. You can have just simple liver test abnormalities, let's say due to a medication, where there's zero injury in the liver. You could also have a chronic liver disease that's resulted in cirrhosis, but you don't have any symptoms from it. And then, of course, unfortunately, there are situations where you develop more advanced liver disease. The goal will always be to preserve your own liver rather than trying to get you over to a liver transplant. A Mediterranean diet that's rich in vegetables and lean proteins and healthy fats has been shown to have benefit in fatty liver disease as well as other liver diseases. But people do like to hear about superfoods. And the one superfood that I think that I can endorse is, believe it or not, coffee. Black filtered coffee has actually been shown to have really tremendous benefits in the liver. The more coffee you drink, the lower your risk of developing cirrhosis if you drink a lot of alcohol is. Now, that's not to say that you should drink a lot of alcohol and that coffee will save your life, but that we do see a protective effect of coffee on the development of liver cirrhosis as well as the development of liver cancer. So it's been a major focus of our liver clinic to help patients with weight loss. And we've done this by getting specialized training in obesity medicine. And one of the most rewarding things that I do in the liver clinic is helping people feel enabled to help them lose weight. I think that because the liver does so many things, there are often a lot of myths and misconceptions.